So, today, I thought I'd go through some of the big things that we're going to be seeing in the last DLC for Battlefield 4, Final Stand. For those of you that don't know, and I'd be really surprised if you didn't, this DLC has been available in the CTE sort of version of Battlefield 4 now for about a week at the moment, and it has also been available previously about a month ago for us to test out and try and get rid of some bugs and things like that. But what it did give us is a really good overlook of how this DLC is going to play out. So I thought I'd just put all of that information into one video, just so that everybody can be caught up with exactly what they should be expecting from this final DLC. So first up, you have your standard four maps. Now these are all themed around 2142. For those of you that don't know, Battlefield did have a futuristic kind of fling at one point, and they made a game called Battlefield 2142. And the idea of these maps is supposed to be sort of like a prologue to what actually happened in 2142. So it's kind of like a homage to that game, really. And a lot of the locations are sort of what you'd expect from all-out Battlefield. Those big open expanses for you to play with vehicles, but they have worked in some tighter infantry-centric locations as well. Those four maps are as follows. Operation Whiteout, which is pretty much a snowstorm map in the middle of a desert in the Russian Arctic. You then have Giants of Karelia, which is set in the Russian tundra and revolves around sort of like the central location where walkers could actually have been made. We also have Hammerhead, which is sort of like another open snowstorm map, but it's got a large frozen lake and sort of a hill beacon in the middle. It's one of the maps that I really like from the DLC. And the last one, Hangar 21, which is the Walker Factory from 2142. Now, footage of all of those four maps will be rolling around in the background during this video, so at least you can have a good look at what you could come to expect from this DLC. Now, moving on to a couple of other things, there will be no sort of new primary equipable weapons with this DLC, which was a disappointment to some people, but I would have to argue that there are already a lot of weapons in Battlefield 4, and sometimes DICE can struggle to balance those, so I think it's good that we're not seeing any primary weapons, but what we are seeing are some really cool gadgets for us to play with. First up, we have the Rorsch X1. This is Battlefield 4's own railgun, and it's really cool to use. Basically, if you hit the fire button, there's a couple of seconds where the thing will charge up and then fire a projectile extremely fast all the way across the map. There's virtually no travel time with it, although it is detectable extreme long ranges, and it can do massive damage to armored vehicles as well. So overall, if you get your hands on this thing, I think you're going to destroy some people. Next up, we have the Exhibitor. And this is sort of like a remote-controlled MAV that you can shoot down people from the sky. It has unlimited ammunition, but it does have like a battery, so you can only use it for a certain amount of time. It's really, really effective against infantry, but not so much on vehicles. If you do get your hands on it, though, make sure you post your massive 15-kill streak up to YouTube. That thing is really powerful. Next up is the decoy gadget. This is equipable and you can use it as your soldier. So you can carry it around with you and then drop it on the ground. I think it's fairly self-explanatory what this thing actually does. It basically just shows up on the minimap a section of where you might be for the enemy, but really it's just a fake. After you've dropped it, a couple of seconds after, it will activate, which means you can sort of run away a little bit, not be detected, wait for the enemy to come around the corner, and then shoot him in the back, go and pick the thing up and carry on again. Think it's a nice addition, but we'll have to see how it plays out. And finally, a look at a couple of new vehicles. We're going to be getting to use the snowmobile, which is really quite cool. It's kind of sort of relevant considering the maps that we're going to be playing on. And the hover tank. And this is probably the best addition for vehicles into the game. You control where it goes with the mouse and where you're aiming, but the WASD keys no longer sort of steer where your tank is going. It fires like rocket blasters at the ground. The thing hovers, and it's much harder to control than a normal tank. And it does take some getting used to. But it is really fun to use, and I think it'll give a new challenge to people who do like to use those ground vehicles. In terms of facts, that's pretty much everything. I can give you a little bit of insight into the maps you're going to be playing. I think overall you'll probably really enjoy Hangar 21. There's a massive expanse outside on the side of the hill before you get to the hangar, which is great for sort of aerial combat and grounds combat as well. You might not think so, but you can get some really good infantry battles going on down there. And when you do get inside the hangar, that's where it lights up for infantry combat. It is long-range combat, and it's still good for snipers and pretty much any sort of length of sort of combat that you want to play with, but at the same time, it's really focused on infantry combat, so you really will like it in there. Giants of Corellia is a little bit of a strange one. I'd have to say that sort of if you're in a ground vehicle, you may dominate on this map, although playing with the jets as well, you've probably got a really good idea. It's a really massive open airspace on that map. There's a little bit of inside going on, but it's really not as heavy as Hangar 21. You are going to want to stick with a vehicle on that map. On to some of the others. Operation Whiteout, that's pretty much an open expanse of snow outside. Very little cover for infantry players. You're going to do really well in a grounds vehicle and maybe just try and take as much cover as you can. You're probably going to want to play as the engineer class on that map more than anything else. And finally, you have Hammerhead, and that map is a great map for rush. Although I will say, the snowflakes that are falling continually throughout the map can be very distracting, and you can lose sort of sense of where you are very quickly. So make sure you always buddy up with a teammate if you're going anywhere. And that's about really it. That's all you really need to know about Final Stand, because it's not going to be long now before it comes out. I would say probably within the next month or so, leading up to the end of October, is when we're likely to see this thing drop. Wouldn't be surprised if it did move into November, but I've got a feeling that it's going to drop right around the end of October. So thank you very much for watching today. If you did enjoy the video, don't forget to leave a rating and a comment down below. It is always appreciated. But until next time, my name is Westy, and I'll catch you guys in the next video.